Hello, I'll play for you a pavane by Luis Milan of the 16th century, Spain. Sons. Thank you. going to play Danza del Altiplano by Leo Brower. So this is a charango. This is an indigenous variant of the guitar, cordophone, as the ethnomusicologists like to call string instruments. And it's likely a development from the Spanish guitar, or even cousins of the Spanish guitar, like the bandurria, which is played a lot in popular ensembles in Spain. So it was developed by the indigenous people of the Americas, and it reflects their preference for high registers. So you can strum it. Or you can also pluck out some very pretty melodies. Well, hello. I'm now demonstrating the way that the guitar is played as part of summer solstice ritual observances in Cayambe, Ecuador. This is an area where I did some Fulbright research close to 30 years ago now. I can't believe it's been that long. Anyway, I was on the search for Galindo tunings, which are these scorditura, that is, unusual tunings of the guitar. There are seven known tunings in the area, the zone of Cayambe, which is a town about 30 to 45 minutes north of the capital of the country, Quito. And this is an area in which the guitar is played as accompaniment to coplas, which are folkloric poetry that represents the thinking of the people. And it's on many different topics having to do with daily living and many about love. So the particular tuning I'm demonstrating is called Guano Pamba, and you can think of it as if I tuned the guitar to a B flat major chord. So D, B flat, F, D, B flat, F. So what this makes it possible to do is to play a tune, so where two fingers play the melody in octaves and the rest of the strings act as drones. This is a very effective way of playing during the ritual, which can take place for about 10 days, usually. But in Cayambe, it's actually 8 weekends. They call this Las Octavas de Cayambe, 8 weekends proceeding from June the 29th, which is the principal festival date, and pretty close to the summer solstice. So what we're going to do is demonstrate how you can either play with fingers 1 and 2, or as one of my informants told me, if those fingers start to bleed, because it is a ritual observance after all, and not just fun and games, you have to keep going, endurance is prized, you start to play with these two, with the third and fourth fingers. So the particular tune I'll demonstrate was taught to me by Camilo Torres, a guitarist of the zone who has been teaching this style of technique to many young people, but has his own very popular music group that has performed internationally and, of course, in the zone, and has many commercially released recordings as well. The tune is called Verbena. Verbena is a kind of wildflower of the zone, and in the song lyric, it stands in as a metaphor for love. Love being something which is beautiful, but also can be dangerous, can be heartbreaking, can be poisonous. So verbena is a plant which is pretty to look at, but don't make a tea or put it in your cooking because it's poisonous. And here's verbena. Or unisons in some case. The other strings act as drones, and so you get either a major chord, major tonality, or the minor tonality. This is very typical of Andean music of the indigenous communities. You go back and forth between the major key and the relative minor. In this case, B flat major and G minor. So that's a little bit of information about the Galindo tunings of Cayambe, Ecuador. We'll continue with our lecture. Thanks. 3 movements from Suite del Recuerdo bajo Sue Luis Berlin. José Luis Medellín is an Argentinian guitarist composer, and this suite is dedicated to the mothers of the Plaza of May, las madres de la Plaza de Mayo, and to Atahualpa Yupanqui. ¶¶ Yucatan by the Argentine and Catalan guitarist Maria Luisa Anido.
Thank you.
In E minor by Hortemodette.
Thank you.